could say that we made it. Bring the bass in. Nah, I meant that literally though. Ooh, yeah, nigga. Get the yayo. Self-educated. Real nigga celebrated. Dedicated to the process. So, my peoples, what the business is, this your boy CheChe GetDaYayo. And you now tuned into the Ambassador Vibez podcast, where we display principle, logic, and splendor. I'd like to welcome all y'all out there that's rocking with us for taking time out of y'all busy schedule in order to do so. I'd like to thank y'all. Your presence is greatly appreciated. Well, this is an introductory episode to the podcast. While we be implementing multiple different formats on this platform, you know, including a variety of topics, current events, fashion reviews, food and restaurant reviews, and we're going to test drive and review some new whips, interviews with entertainers, entrepreneurs, and other major influential individuals that's in my network of reach, and we're going to have some open debates with some future guest hosts, and some more shit. And also, I got visuals to my podcast episodes of the future as well. You know, that's going to be coming up later on, you know what I mean? So stay tuned and be on the lookout for that. But with me being a known artist here in Cincinnati, a known lyrical artist, I should say, I personally enjoy the in-depth analysis portion of this platform where I break down song lyrics, movie scenes, and scenarios and give my observation and perspective on the matter with the intentions of presenting the teaching tool and bringing it to the awareness of the audience. So with that being said, I'll start this off with an artist that, in my humble opinion, one of the greatest spitters to ever breathe on the mic. Of course, I'm talking about the incomparable Nas. What makes Nas so iconic in his persona, which embodies the essence of pure hip-hop. His stellar rhyme schemes, and diction, his attentive to details in his bars, his flow pretty much make him the prototypical modern-day MC, even to this day. He's a lyricist, so to speak. But perhaps the most exceptional quality that he has in his repertoire is storytelling ability. An area in which, in my humble opinion, in my personal humble opinion, he can only be rivaled by the legendary, iconic, pioneer in his own right, Slick Rick, which is hip-hop's original godfather of storytelling. You know, and while we on the subject of Slick Rick, Nas' style is pretty much Slick Rick. It's a mixture of Slick Rick, Coogi Rap, Rakim, sprinkled with a little bit of KRS-One, evenly distributed into a finely blended product we know now as Nasty Nas. So basically, I'm saying he's crack. There were many examples of Nas records that I could have chosen from to support my theory. From One Love off of Illmatic, in which the last verse of the record was reenacted for the acclaimed hood flick Belly. You know that scene where, you know, he chilling with Shorty on the park bench. He come back to the projects. He chilling with Shorty on the park bench, smoking with him. You know what I mean? Giving him some game and shit. You know what I mean? He gave him some jewels, you know? Like, both literally and mentally. You feel me? Like, figuratively speaking. But okay, you know, I could have went, I gave you power from It Was Written. You know, that's an important record because a lot of people don't know that that record actually inspired the great, iconic, revolutionary Tupac, aka Machiavelli, to record Me and My Girlfriend, you know. So, even though Pac and Nas, they had, you know, they differences or whatnot, I believe that there was, you know, an era of mutual respect for each other's craft and for what each other stood for, you know what I mean? I think they both inspired each other, you know. And if it was true that they squashed their beef, or whatnot and was planning on doing something to unify, you know what I'm saying, the culture, man, I would have loved to see that. You feel me? Like, but anyway, let's see. You got Undying Love off of I Am. You know what I mean? Oh, yeah. Who Can Forget Rewind off of Stillmatic? But Nas Tell a Story in total reverse. You know what I mean? That was dope. Like, you know what I mean? That was just something I never even heard of. You feel me? Like, very innovative. You feel me? Like extremely innovative. But, you know, I think the prime example of Nas' top tier storytelling ability is a record called Small World off the same I Am album. This was a song that was conducted and constructed more like a audio book is now. You know how them audio books like Audible and all that be nowadays? Like, that's pretty much what Nas, what Small World is. You feel me? It's like an audio book. Like, it ain't even like a typical rap song. You know what I mean? Like, excuse me. Now, if there was any perceived weakness that Nas may have as an artist, or what's this, Achilles heel, what people would say, you know, a lot of people are critical of his beat selection, which, in my personal opinion, I think that most of the instrumentals that Nas chooses and raps on just complements his style of rap. And, you know, people who says that, they only say it as an excuse for his content going over their heads. You know what I mean? It's like if Nas just rapped over like just mass 808s and Fruity Loop sounds, and, you know, it's going to drown out and take away from his strongest quality in song making, which is his lyrics and his bars. You feel what I'm saying? Like, so I feel like his instrumentals just complements, you know what I mean, his content, so to speak. You feel me? Like, with other artists, they need, you know, a banging ass beat and all of that. They need that top notch production in order to get some attention, because people gonna listen to the beat first, then listen to the words. You know what I mean? Where with Nas, most of the time you listening to his words more so than the beat. You know what I mean? You don't go check out a Nas project and be like, man, I wonder what type of beats, you know what I mean, he got on it. You feel me? You gonna be checking out Nas for, I wonder what he gonna say. You feel me? I wonder what he's talking about on this album. You know what I mean? Like, you gonna be intrigued by that. You know, but, you know, I say I was gonna keep this platform as non-biased as possible. And, you know, he is one of my favorite artists of all time. So, you know, I'm gonna leave that open to discussion. Anywho, the beat for Small World, though, to me, it provides a perfect backdrop for Nas' story. You know, suspenseful and cinematic, which sets the tone and perfectly meshes with Nas' flow. The strings in the background emphasizes the twists, turns, and climax in the story as Nas' lyrics paints a picture so vivid. Feels like you was there. Okay, so without further ado, let's get into it.
See no evil, fear no evil, speak no evil, hear no evil. If you don't bring that shit around you, you ain't got nothing to worry about.
I like how Nas says that with a slight sarcastic tone, you know.
Carolyn from Maryland, she Lady Heroin, she elegant, her apparel in the M-class caravan, keys are dope, loving cats to ski in her throat, she fuck killers in her condo, her Benz in her boat, her ice throat, ass is curvy, 40 years old, she passing for 30, Gucci frame glasses from Purdy's, Madison Ave, shopping when she not, copping bricks of that shit, she hopping on dicks, riding ponies, she tricked, at my man's wake, she said the eulogy, after that I usually bumped into her shopping for jewelry, her bodyguard screwing me, I gave her my math, ain't nothing new to me, blowing backs out, six pack stouts, wide fat mouth, the evil look, with a bow leg, yo nigga said, shorty's a pro, she blow head, she puts the faux red, she no fans. Fans know her. A co-red, maybe she stopped to slay me. This bitch is crazy. She blew the celly up. Meet me at the telly to fuck. She knew about cats from way back. We smoked a haystack. She never coughed once. Blunts was a hobby. She said I knew her man probably. No doubt. Now since he tried to rob me, I did it though. Sometimes you never know. He snorted all her work. Now she need me to do a dirty work. It's a small world, nigga. You reap what you sow. What goes around comes around. If you sleep, you don't know. A very small world where beef could never end. At the time you least expected, I'ma see you again. It's a small world. You get away with it now. Soon enough, it catches up to you some way, somehow. Yo, it's a small world. Watch what you do. Watch what you do. Snook from Red Hook was crimey, did 5 years. Glad to be home from Attica, known for keeping chrome calibers smooth like a wallaby shoe. He's out to get it, 5 years, planning to blow. Soon as he hit the critics, had a girl in Woodside, Queens. Thought he was low, played the crib for a month, indebted his P.O. Started robbing niggas till he caught a whole kilo. He had a bunch of starving niggas, he owed. He never paid though. Got large, signing his door, don't knock hard. Laying with his bitch, niggas is rich, it's what he told her. Played the block, holding cracks inside the baby stroller. Here come his crazy soldier, six shots is over. A year went past, snook with floss and flash. His old man had crossed his ass for the laws of this fast cash. It's a small world, nigga, reap what you sow. What goes around comes around. If you sleep, you don't know. A very small world where beef could never end. At the time you least expected, I'ma see you again. It's a small world, you get away with it now. Soon enough, it catches up to you some way, somehow. It's a small world, watch what you do. I seen death, seen thugs cry. It's bug while we let the slugs fly into your brain, through your skull, another thug die. Picture your soul into that infinite black hole where many souls go cause of a 4-4 blast. Snook was one of them, so many more. Even at Fendi Hall, got niggas hit up, yeah, let the Henny pour. Cavalin', paid up bitch, made bitch, stayed rich. Heard a bodyguard, took Snook to guard. Cavalin', when she needed him, he took the job. He was close to her, ever since she took him inside. When his mom died, dope fiend, OD, 85. He went crazy, stuck up banks to stay alive. He was live to niggas, even though the things that he tried. Robbed armor trucks, incidents with police died. He stayed in Lower East Side, peace God. He standing me hard, two of his men with him. I got to hit him. I reach for my Roscoe, cock the back on to get my blast on at the gas station. Bunch of Arabs racing out the way as my Taurus spray. Jump in the whip, hit the highway. You know how I say the game that I play. It's real tendencies when you feel your enemies but can't figure out who's who. Keep it true, shit it's cool now. Put the tools down, never, cause every day is on. Living this life, I'm for this cheddar. It's a small world, nigga, you reap what you sow. What goes around comes around. If you sleep, you won't know. A very small world where beef never ends. At the time you least expect it, I'ma see you again. It's a small world, you get away with it now. Soon enough it catches up to you some way, somehow. It's a small world, watch what you do.
Yeah, yeah, y'all. If that was y'all first time hearing that record, I suggest y'all go on to YouTube, Spotify, Apple Music, Pandora, Tidal, whatever music service y'all rocking with, and go ahead on and type in Nas-Small World in the search bar and go ahead and rock out to that joint a few times so y'all could fully grasp and comprehend the storyline and the messages in this record. Like, because I ain't going to hold you. When I just went back to listen to this joint, while I was going ahead and prepping for this podcast episode, it was a few subtle details that I had missed that I picked up on, you know what I mean, just from listening to that record just now. So, and I've been listening to that record since it very first came out in, what, like 99, like 98, beginning of 99 type shit. Well, anyway... You know, the synopsis of this story, you got Carolyn. And she's depicted in this record as a well-respected, well-connected, high-maintenance, seductive, attractive woman that's, you know, she's well known in the game. You feel what I'm saying? Like, and she's real deep in the game. She's sort of like a, well, she is basically like a female kingpin, basically. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, what's crazy is the thing about women that's, like, active for real in a game that's, like, real active, a lot of times those women are more treacherous than the men that's actually in the game. Now, of course, the men may be more imposing physically, but it's other attributes, like I just mentioned, you know, well-connected, well-respected, well-known, very seductive, very attractive, you know. She kind of like a, basically a trophy for a dude, you feel me, because of her expensive taste. Let me see. You know, and she's very seasoned, I should say, sexually. You feel what I'm saying? Like, and that's another element that she could use to manipulate and exploit whatever she needs to in order to stay afloat in the game. You feel what I'm saying? Like, to stay ahead of everybody. You know what I'm saying? Like, and, you know, women by nature are very, like, deceiving and manipulative, you know what I mean? Or can be, you know. I'm not going to sit here and say that all women are this, that, and the third, but a lot of times in a lot of situations, I'm going to just put it like that, it could be very manipulative, you know what I mean? Now, a lot of times it gets overlooked because the intentions may not be as malicious as life or death as it is in this record. But, you know, at the same time, you know, when a woman can, they could play certain angles that a man can't. You feel what I'm saying? They could pull certain strings. They could be able to gather information about what's going on a lot of times that men ain't able to. You feel me? Like, people will divulge information to a woman, you know what I mean, before they will a man, especially a man that's been perceived as a threat, you feel me? Because a lot of times women, even if they in the streets and they active, they a lot of times get perceived as, like, innocent, harmless, you know what I'm saying? Like, and a lot of people, they'll let their guard down. Whereas a man, especially that's one that's perceived as a threat, they'll keep their antennas open, you know what I'm saying? They'll be on high alert, you feel me? Like, okay, like, prime example, like, for those listeners that's, like, really from the trenches, if I was to pull up on your block right now, unannounced, you know what I mean, with niggas outside, they all gonna look at me. They gonna be looking at me with the side eye. You know what I mean? Like, damn, who the fuck is this nigga? Like, shit, you know him? Like, shit, what he on? Like, you know what I mean? Liable to get approached. Like, shit, who you looking for? Who you know right here? Who you know that be right here, bro? Like, shit, you looking for somebody? Like, what you looking for? What's up? Like, you know what I mean? Like, even if you, like, embrace me, you know what I'm saying? Be like, nah, man, that's, you know what I mean? That's my boy, CheChe, man. You know, he the one nigga who do the Ambassador Vibez podcast. Like, you know what I mean? Like, this, that, and the third, right? Like, motherfucker be like, oh, all right. Niggas is still going to be looking at me, you know, kind of sideways, you feel me? Trying to figure me out, trying to, you know, check my temperature, you know what I'm saying? They might not do it, like, blatantly, but they still going to try to feel me out, figure me out, you know what I'm saying? And I had to do a whole lot more, you feel me? Like, it'd take a lot longer for me to get accepted, you know what I mean? And I know that for a fact, because I used to be on that type time and shit. Like, if it's a motherfucker I ain't know that I just seen lingering around, or, you know what I mean, that was around in the area and I never seen them before, like, first I'm going to check to see if, you know what I mean, who the fuck dude is. I'm going to ask somebody around me, like, shit, you ever seen him before? Shit, this your peoples, you feel me? Like, you know what I mean? Like, And a motherfucker be like, shit, now I don't know what it is, shit. Well, it's time to press down, you feel me? Like, either a motherfucker better say the right shit or they gonna have to bounce, you feel me? Like, now, with a woman, especially a attractive, seductive woman, you feel me, coming through in them same environments, like we all know, like, a motherfucker more than likely is gonna try to get on with her, you feel me? Like, nigga gonna shoot they shot, flat out, like, you know what I mean? Motherfucker is gonna be more likely to engage in conversation and dialogue with her, you feel me? Like, they may reveal some things, you feel me? Some information probably that shouldn't even be spoke on, you feel me? Like, and the whole time, shorty might just be sitting back, just giggling, just laughing, just, you know, repeating the same few bars, you feel me? Like, oh, shit, you crazy. Or this, that, and the third, you know what I mean? Like, you know, whole time, nigga going off, you know what I mean? Telling all his business, telling all his partner's business, you know what I mean? Telling the block business, you know what I mean? Telling the gang business, whatever the case may be, you feel me? Like, just telling niggas business, period. Pillow talking, you feel me? Like, all of that gossiping, you know what I mean? You'll be surprised. Like, it'll be the toughest, most gangster nigga. Like, you feel me? Like, and then it'll be the main ones and shit. Like, you feel me? Like, man, fuck around, invite shorty to the spot where everything is at, you know what I mean? And be pulling out pound bags just to roll up a joint. You feel me? Like it gets crazy. Like, you know what I mean? Like, and the whole time, shorty could be just sent there, you feel me, on the low as surveillance. You feel me? Like, to gather all this intel, you feel me? And then niggas wonder why a spot get hit, or niggas wonder, like, even if shorty ain't even skep herself, like, you might tell her some shit, and then she'll fuck around and be at the nail shop or the beauty parlor, you feel me, and be talking to her friend or a girl that she know that be at that same nail shop or beauty parlor, and her nigga a jack boy, you feel me? Like, so she picking up information, she getting information from, you know what I mean, for the other shorties that's in there, you know what I mean, that's doing the same thing. They might be on the other side of town fucking with a nigga, you know what I mean? Like, fucking with this nigga, like, you feel me? That's what they do, you feel me? They get together, they start talking about, you know, niggas in different hoods and shit like that, you feel me? Like, they're doing this, that, and the third. You might only really majority just primarily be on your side of town, like, you know what I mean? Like, shorty is getting information from niggas is down the way, west side, Mount Auburn, Vine Hill, you feel me? Like, Madisonville, like, all these different areas, you feel me? Like, and, you know, sometimes that'll be a good thing, because if you got a shorty that's really down on your team, you feel me? Like, because I know one time and shit, it was a real bad drought, like, and shorty, she used to fuck with somebody that still had it. You feel what I'm saying? Like, it was playing fair. You feel me? Like, but she ain't really want to tell me because she ain't want me to be privy to dude, or, you know what I mean? She thought I was going to trip because they used to talk. I'm like, shit, I don't give a fuck about that. Like, you know what I mean? I'm trying to get some money. Like, you feel me? Like, so sometimes it could be a good thing. You know what I mean? Sometimes a woman can connect you to some shit, you feel me, or vice versa, you feel what I'm saying? Like, but, you know, if shorty ain't on your team, like, and you don't, or you think she on your team but she's really not, you know, it could definitely be costly, you know what I mean? Like, and in this situation, what Nas is talking about, like, you feel me, like, they link up, you feel me, they already was kind of like intertwined, you know what I mean, mingling around in the same circles, because, of course, when you in that echelon of the game, you know what I mean, when you get to the upper echelon, you feel me, you gonna know the who's who or who doing things and who's handling, you feel me? Like, you gonna know that, you feel me, just because of the same circles. Y'all might go to the same club, might get your hair cut at the same barbershop. You feel me? Like, you might done seen shorty, you know what I mean? Like, anywhere, this section, with this nigga that you knew, you feel what I'm saying? Or you might have seen her with, you know what I'm saying, some other girls and shit. You feel what I'm saying? You might have seen her, you know what I mean, bust some moves, and you hip to her. Like, you feel me? Like, it's a whole lot of ways, like, people link up. You feel me? Like, so, long story short, they linked up. And, you know, Nas already got the scouting report on her. And that's another thing. A lot of times, niggas don't really get the full scouting report on these women, or they don't even bother to try. You feel me? They just be like, damn, shorty fine. Like, she giving me rhythm and shit. Like, she act like she like me. You feel me? Like, I like her. And that be that without getting the whole detail. You know, it's like a scouting report. Like it might be a plural that's coming out. And, you know what I mean? A motherfucker might jump the highest. You know what I mean? Got the biggest arm. You know what I mean? Like, just a super talented, but the nigga injury prone. You feel me? Like, or he got off the field issues that hinder his on the field production, or he might be a cancer in the locker room. You feel me? It's the same thing when you evaluating females. Like, you really gotta gather as many references as you can. You feel me? Like, to judge her true character, because you could think shorty one way and she turned out to be a whole nother way. You feel me? And you won't. By the time you find out, it'd be too late. You know what I'm saying? So Nas got the scout report, because when he said, you know what I mean, my nigga say shorty's a pro. She blow head. She puts the faux red. She no feds. Feds know her. You feel me? Like, so he was already kind of like leery, you know what I'm saying, linking up with her. But he ended up linking up with her for real. And this, that, and the third, whatever the case may be. And eventually, you know what I mean, she wanted him to handle some shit. Like, when he said, he snorted all her work. Now she need me to do her dirty work. You feel me? Like, that was that. You feel me? Like, which brings me to Snook. Snook from Red Hook. I had a homeboy from Brooklyn and shit. He was from Red Hook. I used to call that nigga Snook from Red Hook. Like, yeah, but, yeah, Snook from Red Hook. Like, you feel me? Like, now he depicted as, you know, like a real street nigga, grimy as hell, you feel me, to bust a move on you, you know what I'm saying, play for keeps, you feel me, like, you know what I mean, whoring criminal, did time, he just did a stretch, you know what I mean, and the one thing I noticed about niggas who, like, do stretches, especially if they was real active before they stretch, is that a lot of times, you know what I mean, if a nigga don't really properly get his mind right, or ain't in an environment, in a space to where he can get his mind right, you feel me? Like, he's going to try to make up for the lost time, the time he lost when he was in a can. You feel me? Like, you know what I mean? He gonna try to, you know, make up for that lost time and shit. So when he get out, you're going to be anxious to get out, you know what I mean, to continue back on to what he was doing. You know, of course, niggas gonna think they smarter and, you know, be more slick, and they fortress is gonna be much better than it was that what got them in there. You feel me? But, you know, niggas always try to make up for lost time. You know, they get out, yeah, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna bust this move, I'm gonna holler at this nigga, I'm gonna do. My niggas already out there handling, you feel me? This, that, and the third, they gonna already got a phone for me. You know what I mean? All of that. But see, the thing they don't really take into account, you know what I mean, is that the world that's on the outside changes, you know what I mean? They was in a controlled environment pretty much, you feel me? Like, so it's pretty much the same activities going on every day in that motherfucker, you feel me? Like, you know what I mean? Nigga go in the yard, work out, you feel me? Like, you know what I mean? Might kick it on the yard with some niggas and shit. Might hit a couple sticks, you feel me? Like, I mean, get on the phone, read some mails. You know, a lot of times what niggas do, though, they bit through the seasons. Like, right now is the conference championship games in football and shit. Like, so if a nigga was from, like, August to whenever the Super Bowl ends, you know, that's 6 months. You feel me? And then you got March Madness and shit like that, like, and the NBA playoffs and shit. Like, it get kind of dry when, you know what I mean, after the finals and shit. You feel me? Like, that baseball period, unless a nigga is just going to get into baseball, you feel me? Like, not too many niggas is into that. But, you know, niggas bit off of seasons. Niggas bit off of pretty much anything. You feel me? Like, but more often than not, the activities is going to pretty much be the same. You feel me? Like, and then when a nigga get into a routine, his time start to go by faster, or he adapts to his surroundings more. But on the outside, shit is changing every day. You know, the shit that was going on yesterday, liable not to be going on no more. Something totally different. You know what I mean? Like, so as the situations and times change, people change. So before Snook did his little fireball, you know what I'm saying? Like, niggas was probably, he was probably having his way, you know what I mean? He's probably taking shit from niggas, putting fear in niggas, you know what I mean? Busting moves, popping niggas, had a hellified, bulletproof reputation, you know what I'm saying? Like, had mass allies and niggas that's respecting them, niggas that's gonna ride for him, this, that, and the third, you know? And pretty much had the street shook, you know what I mean? Like, now, that's 5 years is unpassed. I know I just said a little 5 years. That's just slang. That shit is not little at all. That's a pretty significant chunk out of your life. You feel me? Like, it's 60 months, man. Shit changed drastically in that time frame. You got little niggas that's, you know what I mean, coming of age. It was a little nigga when you went in. Come out, this nigga coming of age. Now he a big dog. Like, he was in the position that you was in. Like, and, you know, motherfuckers might have had bowed down when you was in there, but niggas ain't bowed down now. You feel me? Like, you know what I mean? The same niggas you used to be, that used to be scared of you, they ain't as scared of you no more. Like, you not as invincible to them niggas. You feel me? Like, they done, while you was in there, they done, you know what I mean, gained some stripes of their own, so now they looking at you as potentially a bigger stripe. You feel what I'm saying? Like, the niggas that was on your side, that was on your team, like, a lot of them may not be around no more. You know what I'm saying? Nigga might get locked up they damn self. Nigga might, you know what I'm saying, end up getting boxed. You feel me? Like, niggas, you know, might fuck around and change their life. You know, people... Niggas who you hang with, just think of the niggas you hung with 5 years ago. Like, you know what I mean? Like, it may be still a few niggas that you hang with, a couple of niggas that you still rock with. You feel me? Even if you rock with them, y'all, the dynamics of y'all relationship is not going to be the same. You feel me? Like, you know what I mean? Some niggas settle down, they get families, niggas move, relocate. You feel me? They ain't even around there on that block no more. They got some other shit going on. This nigga done moved to Texas or something. You feel me? Like, I moved to the A. You feel me? Like, all that. Like, you know, a nigga might find out a nigga ain't real no more, or a nigga wasn't as real as you thought. You feel me? Like, they got some other shit going on and you can't rock with them no more. Like, you feel me? Like, now it's a whole new set of niggas. It's a whole new set of generations and shit. Or niggas that wasn't hanging with each other or rocking with each other, now they rocking with each other. Or niggas that was rocking with each other, now they beefing with each other. And I remember one time I came home and I was right in the middle of some shit. It was some internal conflict type shit between my niggas and shit. Like, you know what I mean? Between my niggas and some other niggas that we was rocking with. You feel me? Like, but now, like, niggas ain't seeing eye to eye and shit. And for real, it's about to be up, so I went from coming home thinking I'm going to stay on a straight and narrow and, you know what I'm saying, and really upgrade my mannerisms and, you know what I mean, be doing, you know what I mean, elevating shit, to now I'm coming home and it's like, shit, nigga, just give me the biggest strap you got. You feel me? Like, you know what I mean? Shit changed like that drastically. So, yeah, I say that to say this, like, you know, how Snook was depicted, you know what I mean? He thought he was going to go, come home, pick up where he left off. He actually did. You know what I'm saying? Like, and I get the perception that he was a robbery boy, a stick-up kid. I know he was grimy as hell. You feel me? Like, So, you know, he doing shit. He running off on niggas. He finessing niggas and shit until he could, you know what I mean, get some money and shit. He get him a little bitch, you feel me? Like, they get a spot together and shit, whatnot. Like, you feel me? Like, and like I was just saying about Carolyn, you see what Nas said, like, you know what I mean? Laying with his bitch, niggas is rich. That's what he told her. You feel me? Holding cracks inside the baby stroller. So he basically using her to help him with his capers and shit. You feel me? Like, basically. So, you know, and eventually shit'll catch up to Snook. You feel me? Like, you know what I mean? He get dealt with, you feel me? And then it's a key bar when Nas said, you know what I mean, a year would pass, Snook could floss real fast. I'm just saying this, paraphrasing. He say his old man had crossed his ass for the loss of his fast cash. Like, so basically, say Snook old man had crossed him. You feel me? Like, so that may be far-fetched to a lot of people, you know what I mean? Like, I know I got a pretty solid relationship with my dad, like a real solid relationship, you feel me? But, you know, everybody doesn't have that solid relationship with their father or their parents, period, you feel me? Like, you know what I mean? I know niggas who, even if their dad wasn't around, you know, as they got older, they got grown, you know, they got cool, you know what I mean? Like, you feel me? Like, or they was always cool or whatnot, but, you know, they was able to spend more time now that they've grown, you feel me? Like, and, you know what I'm saying? And not, didn't have they mother in between, didn't have his mother in between or his baby mother or whatever the case may be, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, it'd be some niggas who have rocky relationships, like, you know what I mean? Like, with they dads, like, you know what I mean? I done heard about a son killing his dad, or even, you know, dad killing a son, like Marvin Gaye daddy, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? He killed Marvin Gaye, you feel me? Like, so it's not really as far-fetched as you think, you feel me? Like, I get the idea that Carolyn maybe knew Snook father or something, you feel me? Like, and was able to get to him or whatnot, you feel me? Like, probably was what it was. Snook probably wasn't cutting his dad in. You feel me? So, you know what I mean? They probably fell out over that, and his dad was like, shit, fuck him. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you know what I mean? Niggas sell their family members out all the time. You feel me? Like, you know what I mean? As crazy as that may sound, like, you feel me? You seen on the wire where Cheese sold out his own uncle, Prop Joe. You feel me? Like, just so he can advance, you feel me? Like, that's how that shit go, like, you feel me? Like, and that's a, like, a key component, like, you know what I mean? Yeah, because by the time we get to the third verse, Nas pretty much connects the dots somewhat, excuse me, connects the dots somewhat, you know, which is good because it allows the listener to form their own interpretation of the situation, you know what I mean? Like, and to fill in the details that was left out, you know what I'm saying? Like, Nas should give you just enough details to put the story together. Well, yeah, we know who Carolyn was trying to get whack, or was trying to get Nas to whack, you know what I mean? And that was Snook from Red Hook, you know what I mean? Like, Snook had ran off with her work, you feel me? Like, yeah. She wasn't having that shit, you feel me? Like, now when niggas run off, a lot of times it's, like, various excuses. You know what I mean? Some niggas have various excuses, like, oh, man, let's just say if you give a nigga a gun or something like that, like, you feel me? Like, and, you know, a nigga might hit you with the, oh, man, you know, the boys came, I had to toss it, or, you know what I mean? You gave a nigga some work or something, like, and nigga be like, man, yeah, man, like, either the boys got it or, you know what I mean, motherfucker had robbed me or somebody took it, like, or stole it from me or whatnot. You know what I mean? Nigga be like, yeah, man, a boy, I took the boys on a high speed. You know what I'm saying? I had to throw that motherfucker in the river, boy. Like, or I had to throw that motherfucker in the woods. You feel me? Like, or whatever the case may be. But the whole time they perping. The whole time they just trying to cuff your shit. But you know what I mean? It's like that because some niggas, I give a motherfucker the benefit of the doubt and won't, you know what I'm saying, I won't take action, you feel me? Like, but other niggas, they ain't trying to hear that shit, you feel me? Like they really ain't trying to hear that shit, like, you know what I mean? And Carolyn wasn't trying to hear that shit, you feel me? Like, she already knew what Snook M.O. was, you feel me? Like, so, yeah, so it was Carolyn Hitter that did Snook in, and, you know, and Nas said something very, very, like, revealing in the third verse to give you some insight on why Carolyn bodyguard was willing to jump out the window, you know what I'm saying, for. Matter of fact, take it back to the first verse when Nas say, I usually bump into her shopping for jewelry. Her bodyguard screwing me. She gave me her math. Ain't nothing new to me. You feel me? Like, so basically, when he says her bodyguard is screwing me, like, somebody might take, I'm like, what the fuck? Like, is her bodyguard a female? What the fuck is screwing? Like, but really, now I know that was like 90s, New York slang, you feel me? That was like the 90s New York lingo for a motherfucker like mean mugging you, you feel me? Like ice grilling you, you know what I'm saying? Like sizing you up, basically. Like, you feel me? Like, I'm pretty sure you approach somebody you know and then they with somebody that you don't know, but they just keep looking at you. Like, you feel me? Like, keep trying to, you know what I mean, figure you out. Like, you feel me? Like, who the fuck is this nigga? Like, you feel me? Like I just said, if a nigga just pop up on your block, you feel me? Like, and you know what I mean, niggas is gonna have that look, that real like skeptical look, like, man, the fuck? Like, but you know, that just goes to show that how overprotective he was of Carolyn, you feel me, and how serious he was about protecting her and putting in work for her. You know what I mean? Like, and in the third verse, he said, Carolyn, when she needed him, he took the job. He was close to her ever since she took him inside. When his mom's died, dope fiend OD 85. He went crazy, stuck up banks to stay alive. So basically, you know, when people like go through that type of trauma, like losing somebody, like a parent or a real close, like, family member. It could be your grandma. It could be, you know, your favorite big cousin. Like, all of that. When trauma happens like that and you lose somebody, like, early on in life, like, you know what I mean? It causes, like, that person to react, you know what I'm saying? And to fill the void, you know what I'm saying, that was missing. Like, you know what I mean? That love that was missing. Like, you feel me? Like, without that love, they reacting. You know what I'm saying? And until somebody fills that void, you feel me? Like, and Carolyn filled that void that was missing in her bodyguard's life, which is her mom. Like, so basically, Carolyn was almost basically like a mother figure to him. So, of course, anything she said, he was going to do. You know what I'm saying? Like, no matter what, all she had to do was just give him the word. And that goes back to the manipulative aspect that I was talking about earlier. You feel me? Like, so, Nas plans retaliation. Well, really, it was like he caught, you know what I mean, his bodyguard, two other niggas around him, like, you feel me, like, so, he basically, you know what I mean, he basically smoked Carolyn bodyguard, catch him at a gas station, basically smoking for Snook, You feel me? Like, so, you know what I'm saying? Him and Snook had to be obviously close. Like, and then when Nas said, it's cool now, put the tools down, never. You feel me? That right there, I thought was a bar that always stuck out because it's like, you know, in the movies or video games, once you kill a villain or the perceived bad guy, whatever the case may be, or the enemy or whatever the case may be, you thinking like, yeah, like shit is over now, like everything back to normal, but it's not. You know what I mean? Your life drastically changed. Like, you feel me? Like when Kane killed the niggas in Menace to Society, they killed his cousin Harold. You feel me? Like, first thing he said, like, shit, I thought it was going to make me feel better, but it didn't. You feel me? Like, a lot of times it'll make you feel worse. Like, you feel me? Like, you might think, like, killing somebody, if somebody killed your brother, you kill that nigga brother or something like that, or you kill the nigga that killed your brother, that's going to make shit better. But a lot of times, it don't really make shit better, you feel me, in the long run. Like, you know what I mean? It'll make you more darker as a person. It'll, you know what I mean? You'll take on a whole new set of demons, you know what I mean? Make you paranoid, restless, you know, always constantly got to look over your shoulder. Ain't no more hanging out. Ain't no more kicking it. Ain't no more none of that type of shit. You know what I'm saying? And there's seldom times that you do, in the back of your mind, you worry. You be like, damn, is this when, you know what I mean? I remember sometimes stepping out the house, I'd be like, damn, is this the day? Like, you feel me? Like, you know what I mean? Shit gonna catch up. You feel me? Like, and it be like that. And you always gotta, I don't care if it's some shit you did 5, 10, 15, 20 years ago. You feel me? Like, you know what I mean? You might knock this nigga off and you thinking like, yeah, man, like, shit, it ain't gonna do nothing and shit, man. He's a hoe ass nigga. But you don't know how many people actually love this hoe ass nigga. Like, you feel me? It could be somebody who went to school with him and was like, man, I used to play basketball with that nigga every day. Like, you feel me? Like, they were like, nah, man, that's fucked up, man. Fuck that. And this nigga might be a nigga who got Paris. So now you got enemies that you don't even know. Or a nigga cousin that you ain't never even met before. You feel me? Like, that's on that same type of time you is. Probably even more so. You feel me? And he on your ass. He looking for you. You know what I mean? And it don't take much for a nigga to catch up with you, man. Like, you feel me? It don't take much at all. Like, and once a nigga decide, really, really, really decide to catch up with you, you know, he's going, it could take however long, you feel me? Like, it could be, you might mention your name to a female, and that might be that nigga's sister, you feel me? Or somebody that he cool with that's from his hood, you feel me? Or anything, you feel me? Like, it could be a name, you know what I mean? Look, just give me a name, man. Just give me a side of town. You know what I mean? Like, even if a nigga move out of town, just give me a state of where this nigga may be at. You feel me? Like, just give me a state. Give me a city, a zip code, anything. Like, you feel me? Like, give me a neighborhood or any of that, you know what I mean? You ain't got to tell me exactly where you at, you know what I mean? Like, I don't want to put that on your conscience. Just give me anything, any piece of information, and I could use that with the other piece of information that I gathered, you know what I'm saying, to catch up with a motherfucker, you feel me? Like, and that's just how easy it be. And if a nigga can't catch up with you, you know what I mean, they'll catch up with your brother, they'll catch up with your family, they'll even catch up with your mama or your kids. I done been in a room with certain niggas and they was talking and nigga was talking about, man, like, shit, I catch that nigga mama or this, that, and the third. And I'll be like, hold on, wait a minute, you know my mama, man. Like, hold on, man. Let me step out this room real fast. Like, you feel me? Like, it's done been like that. It's done been that serious. You feel me? Like, a nigga, it don't take much for a nigga to catch. Or not even that, it could be a whole nother situation that happens. You feel me? Like, because, you know, things work itself out like that. You know what I mean? Like, it could be something that you did And then it could be a whole nother situation that comes up and you paying, you suffering the consequences from that situation. You might think it's that situation, but really it's something that you already did, that you done planted the seeds. You know, they say you reap what you sow. Nah, I say that in the hook. You feel me? You know, so if you're going to be, this is basically what I'm, the lesson that I learned from this story. If you're going to be, first of all, you never know who's connected to who. You know what I'm saying? So don't underestimate anybody or take anybody for light, for granted or lightly. It could be a nigga that's who you think ain't really a street nigga, but he might get connected to street niggas. You feel me? Like, it could be a nigga who don't look like he's a game banger. Like, man, he look like he's square, you go to school, but he might be affiliated with a serious ass gang. You feel me? Like, it could be a female woman, you thinking like, damn, she just a bitch. Like, but that bitch got a whole lot of connections and does did a whole lot of dirt you don't know about. Don't let that pretty shit fool you. No, pretty smile, the eyes, the fat old ass. You feel me? Like, motherfucker, any of that shit, them lashes, none of that. Don't let none of that shit fool you. That sweet, soft baby voice. You know what I mean? Don't let none of that shit fool you, man. Don't take none of that shit for granted. Like, especially if you live in a lifestyle where you doing dirt and you active. You feel me? Like, you got to always keep it in your mind that you a target and that shit could definitely catch up with you. You feel me? Like, if you living like Snook, I know plenty of Snooks. You feel me? I seen plenty of them come and go. You feel me? Like, if you live in that Snook type of lifestyle, do what you got to do and get the fuck out. You know what I mean? Make the next transition and shit. Don't linger around nowhere too long. I don't give a fuck how, you know what I'm saying, low you think you is and shit, man. Somebody, all it takes is for a little piece of information. You feel me? Motherfuckers got motherfuckers that work at the BMV that, you know what I'm saying, that work for job and family services, that work anywhere that could get your address. You might be a motherfucker. A nigga might have a P.O., bitch. You feel me? And get your low like that. Like, you know what I mean? It's done happened before. Like, so you can't, don't take anything lightly. You know what I'm saying? Like, and number one, if you got the chance, just make sure you do on the others as you would want done to you. You feel me? Like, you know what I mean? Treat people with proper respect. It'll get you further in life. You feel me? Even in the streets, it'll get you further in the streets. A lot of misconceptions that these youngins have is that, you know, I could just be violent and that's going to give me respect. That's going to give me a name. A lot of times, that's how you may lose respect. You feel me? Like, if you just being violent, like, because it's always somebody that's going to be badder than you, that's going to be bigger, badder, tougher, more gangster, smarter, all of that. You know what I mean? Don't ever think you the smartest person or you the only smart person. There's always somebody that's just as smart or smarter. You feel me? Don't ever think that you could just always manipulate a situation, because a lot of times that situation can backfire on you in the long run. But now saying the hook, you get away with it now. You feel me? Like, it come and bite you in the ass in the long run. Real talk. Like, yeah, man. Like, just, you know what I mean? I always try to, you know what I mean? It may take you longer to get somewhere by, you know what I mean, sticking to the script. You feel me? But in the long run, it'll benefit you. You know what I mean? It'll definitely benefit you in the long run. You feel me? It's the difference between having resources and a network in high places to you having enemies in high places that would turn over every stone in order to get you. You feel what I'm saying? Like, so you got to be always careful of that. You know what I mean? Like, always be conscious of that. You know what I mean? You know, being in the streets or being in this game, you can't be a goldfish in a water with sharks and piranhas. You know what I mean? But you can always have some sort of honor, some type of principle and how you carry yourself. It'll get you a whole lot further. Like, trust me, like, you know what I mean? It'll get you a whole lot established. Like, you might get rich quicker being grimy and doing that or get a name, but that shit don't last long. Trust me. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you can't be grimy forever. Like, if you're going to be a robbery boy, make sure you hit one lick to, you know what I mean? And I'm not advocating robbing anybody, but if you're going to be out there, just make sure you hit one lick or a couple licks or something like that and go for the gusto and be able to make the transition into something else. Like, you feel me? Like, if you on the streets and shit and you hustling, you feel me? Like, just, you know what I'm saying? Make sure you accumulate to enough and keep your eyes on the prize and accumulate enough to where you could make a transition. While you hustling, get you develop you a skill or something. You feel me? While you doing that, like, I mean, I done had some homeboys that probably some of the biggest hustlers out there, but, you know, they graduated from Xavier and UC and all that, got bachelor's degree, working on a doctor's degree type shit. Like, you feel me? Like, and that's just something that, you know what I mean, a lot of people don't have the opportunity to do, number one. You feel me? But that's just something that's not really instilled in us like that. You feel me? Like, you know what I mean? I think back to all the niggas who had all that money in my hood, but they ain't buy no properties. They ain't do nothing. You feel me? Like, some niggas did. Like, a couple niggas did. And the niggas that did, you know, they ended up grabbing them. You feel me? Like, you know what I mean? But for the most part, like, you know what I mean? Niggas could have been really buying shit up and shit. You feel me? Like, and having shit. You feel me? Like, even if it's for somebody else. You feel me? In the community. You know what I mean? Now, you know what I mean? Motherfuckers turn down the community. They moving in. They buying shit up and shit. And they really done cut niggas out of their own community. And it's going now on everywhere. You feel me? In the country. You know what I mean? So, it's just, man, like, just try to have, like, you got to have some sort of righteousness about you. Even if you on the streets doing dirt, to kind of, like, balance yourself out. You feel me? Like, to where, I mean, you still going to deal with consequences or repercussions. But at least, you know what I mean, you'll have that balance. You feel me? To help you get through any trials and tribulations that you face. You feel me? Like, and, you know, a lot of motherfuckers, they put in them a type of environments, though, to where it's hard. It's easier said than done. It's easier me saying it, because, like I said, I'm still working on it. So, but, you know, I just say that to encourage and motivate, you know what I'm saying, my people, especially niggas in the trenches, man, to motivate y'all, you know what I mean, elevate and, you know what I'm saying, and take this shit to another level, man, and not keep perpetuating the same cycle and end up in the same path and shit, you feel me, like, as the niggas that came before us and the niggas that came before them and the niggas that came before them and the niggas that's after us and shit, like, you feel me, like, this cycle just keep on going, like, you feel me, and it just keep getting more vicious and vicious as it keeps going, you feel me, like, you know, so you gotta watch for everybody. You gotta watch everybody's intentions, motives, movements, all that, all while at the same time you playing chess in your own moves. And, you know what I'm saying, and you polishing up your own life. You feel me? Like, and, you know, that's just my in-depth analysis. You know what I mean? I hope y'all enjoyed it. You know, this is my first joint. You know what I mean? I'm gonna get better at it with time, you know what I mean? I got some more joints I'm gonna do, you feel me? Like, different joints, you feel me? Like, you know what I mean? I got a few more Nas joints that I'm thinking about doing too, like, you feel me? But, you know, I got E40, Too Short, shit, hell, Master P, you know what I'm saying? Like, all of these people that got, like, messages or songs with messages in them, you feel me? And do an in-depth analysis. And if there's any artists that got that want me to critique their music or whatever the case may be, man, just holler at me, man. I told y'all, man. Follow me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, CheChe GetDaYayo. You know what I'm saying? Have some more shit going on. You know, and This the Ambassador Vibez podcast, man. You know what I mean? Just remember, whatever you do, however you live your life, include principle, logic, and splendor. All right, y'all. One, I'm about to skip this hopscotch tournament.
Say that we made Bring the bass in. Nah, I meant that literally though. Yeah, nigga. Get the yayo, self-educated, real niggas celebrated, dedicated to the process since the beginning stages. Hey, we in the latest, freshly tailored, freshly tapered, bitches savor every taste of the flavor, we highly favored. Hey, swarm like cicadas, barrel with the potatoes, stepping like the old school player with gators, you violators. Hey, they tried to play us, but they effed us, but stagnated us. Now we finally can say that we made it, we highly favored.
Let me count a bit. Matter of fact, let's have a toast for all these counterfeits.